as a nurse, one of the worst things that you can do is leave a patient one round and they're awake, alert, and talking to you, and then coming back in the next hour and finding that patient unresponsive and having no way to have known that was going to happen. That's horrible. It's terrifying. It's not something that ever goes away.
We had had an incident that really was seminal. A relatively young person having a pretty minor procedure. They had pain, they were anxious, they got appropriate care. But again, they were one of those rare people who a small amount went a long way, and they surprised everyone, but they were found dead in their room.
We came to the realization that we could not predict in every patient who would deteriorate. Even though they might be perfectly healthy, they would react to a polypharmaceutical mix that differently than others.
That was really the sentinel case that set our quality and patient safety group here at Dartmouth-Hitchcock off in a quest to make sure that that never happened to another patient.
Really what we were first focused on was this respiratory depression due to opioids. And that particular problem, the oxygen saturation, is just the right signal.
When we started to look for pulse oximetry technology, we found that the Masimo sensor had a lot of technology for rejecting noise and motion.
We found a nurse champion on one of the units that was willing to try this, sold it to nursing that, look, we don't want this to be a monitoring platform. We want it to be a surveillance platform, a safety net.
One thing that's important to note is that we thought of it as a system. It wasn't just buying a monitor. It was thinking through all of the different factors that would come into play, such as what kinds of sensors would be appropriate to use, how would we alarm, where would we alarm, who would the alarms go to, what the settings would be on those alarms.
We had an interdisciplinary approach, so it was, you know, the representatives from Masimo, our biomed, our quality and safety. We surveyed the nurses, we rounded every day. We would say, what makes this work harder for you? What can we do to make it better? And things were changed.
You know, people worry about, well, can we afford this? Is it too expensive? We actually had a return in terms of savings, because instead of having to use the ICU to treat a complication that was preventable, we were detecting that complication, treating it rapidly, and it never led to a multi-day stay in the ICU.
So we saw a reduction of 65% in rescue calls, and we saw a reduction of 48% in transfers to the ICU on that unit. Two of the units without monitoring, we saw no changes in their calls.
We've spread this system to all 200 of our general inpatient beds.
Every patient counts. We're monitoring every patient all the time to fulfill that promise that we made in 2007, that no patient will ever die here when it's preventable. When we can monitor them, we can get resources to the bedside in time to rescue them.
We saw just a profound impact. We have not had a single patient in the 10 years who, while monitored on this system, suffered an opioid overdose death.
In my 36 years of doing this type of work, it's the only time that I can say what I did as a clinical engineer actually saved someone's life.
And we began to notice it catching many things. It wasn't just desaturations. It would be events of bradycardia. We would have patients that maybe missed a dose of medication that affected their heart rate, and suddenly we noticed their heart rate was different. It caught us by surprise. It detected a lot of sleep apnea in patients that nobody knew existed.
We got to a point where we were able to do device integration. So instead of somebody going around and doing vital signs and writing those on a piece of paper and then writing them in the chart after, it directly entered. So we had a system here at Dartmouth where what was on the monitor was directly put into our medical record. So it really did end up saving time. And that was a safety feature because there wasn't the risk of transcription error.
I'm a clinical nurse supervisor at night. I have a lot of new grads on the floor who may not know those initial signs of decline as well. And so what I get as a charge nurse is I have my own Masimo pager that's a backup for all the nurses at the bedside. So anytime a patient has a change, it will initially alarm the nurse at the bedside, but then if it wasn't addressed in enough time, it then goes up to me as the charge nurse. And I have 10 years experience You know, I worked in the ICU. I'm there to support the nurses, and I can go and follow up with that nurse. Like, is your patient having a change right now? How can I be of assistance to you? Do I need to activate an early warning sign or have life safety come to the bedside? And it helps me to target who's having changes on the floor when I'm in charge of 35 patients every night.
So one of the other advantages of the system that we have in place now is that we can monitor patients using a wireless sensor. And for instance, in one of our units where we have a lot of orthopedic surgeries, the patients are up and moving around the same day of their surgery, and this allows them to be monitored while they're doing those laps around the particular unit. And one of the really interesting things about this is that we didn't anticipate was that the physical therapists who are with the patients can now see when events can happen. And it wasn't something that we had really thought a lot about being part of the use case when we were implementing this system, but we hear lots of reports now about events that happen when patients are taking laps, things that hadn't been previously diagnosed or considered being visible when the patient was being monitored continuously while they were ambulating.
The device is very lightweight. The patient sometimes doesn't even know that they have it on. Unfortunately, we've had a couple of cases where the patient went home with it because it was so comfortable to wear that they didn't know that they had it on. So that's really important to allow the patient to move around and not be tethered to the device.
This community depends on this hospital and the people work here. Dartmouth-Hitchcock's the largest employer in New Hampshire. So we literally see people who work here and their family members all the time getting care here. And I think it makes you, I think it's an advantage. We don't have trouble engaging people in our organization around safety. People totally get it, and they get that the care we deliver is the care we receive.